Hello everyone, Chef Jitsu here. Welcome to or back to my channel, whichever the case may be. I'm bringing you another session of the War Room. That's right, time for some more hints, tips, and tricks. The War Room is intended for that sort of thing. Right now I'm focusing on War Thunder because that's really the only game that I post that it's relevant to. I've actually got some Ground Forces stuff in the works as well for the War Room, so keep an eye out for those. There's also a link in the description below if you'd like to see the entire playlist. We've talked about altitude being advantage and boom and zoom tactics. We've also gone over the basics of your hangar. But today, we're going to be talking about energy fighting. Now, in air combat, there's three schools of thought or combat or doctrine, whatever word you want to use to describe it. Anyway, thought being you have boom and zoom, then in the middle you have energy, and last but not least, you have the turn and burn, or turn fighters. And boom and zoom, come from high, pounce on your target, put some lead on them, and then zoom away. Get out before they can do anything. Usually have a heavier plane with a really, really, really good power plant and great energy retention, so you're able to hopefully surprise your enemy and they're not able to chase you. And you just kind of rinse and repeat that process. And then you have turn and burn. Turn and burn planes are usually lighter with a broader wing, which allows them tighter turns at lower speeds. You get a boom and zoom plane at a low speed, at a low altitude, and they are not maneuverable at all. They cannot turn. It's like flying a brick. In fact, a lot of people complain about American planes being flying bricks. And that's because I believe they're utilizing them wrong. But they're right, they are flying bricks. You just gotta know how to throw the brick to make it effective. In between those two, you have the energy fighter. Now, it's considered an energy fighter because it's got a great turning ability and great turning radius, but just can't really compete with a Japanese Zero or, say, a Spitfire. They just can't keep inside of the turn on either of those. They can outturn a boom and zoom plane, no problem. Now, they usually have really, really good climb rates and, again, a very good engine. And this allows them to also be effective boom and zoom. But the problem is, they're kind of what I consider a medium fighter. They're not as big and heavy as a boom and zoom, but they're not as light and don't usually have the broad wings like a Spitfire or a Zero. And so they're not able to turn, and they don't have the weight behind them to be really effective boom and zoom. Again, I do use the boom and zoom a lot with the energy fighters because you're trading altitude for energy, diving on your opponent, and usually you can engage in a turn fight of sorts. It's kind of a modified turn fight. You have to adjust your tactics and style. You can't pull on the stick as hard as you would in an actual turn and burn fighter. So, but again, you can't retain your energy as well. So your zoom isn't as prolonged, and usually you can gain, especially in like the BF-109, you can gain a lot of your altitude back, if not all of it, but you've usually lost all of your speed and energy. So you have to rely again on potential energy, and potential energy is altitude. Energy is your speed plus your altitude. So you're always going to want to try to keep at a fairly decent speed. I try never to go under 250 kilometers per hour if I can help it. Again, because your speed equals your energy. As soon as that's gone and you hit that stall, you start falling out of the air, and your goal is to do that to your enemy. You don't want that happening to you. So we're going to go over some diagrams here and kind of touch on what I talked about, modified turn fighting. And then I'll show you some other clips too on how I use the stalls, and just knowing my plane and how it's going to handle, and knowing the enemy and what they're doing and their relationship to me, their energy state versus my energy state, their potential energy state versus my potential energy state, and just taking total advantage of that. And knowing your plane and knowing your enemy's plane is key, is vital. You have to just know. And nothing is going to do that other than game time. And that's why I am struggling to unlock jets. Because I play every nation. I play every plane because I want to know how they perform. And knowledge is power. Alright, let's get into these little diagrams. Okay. So, get the laughs out, because yes, it's a pathetic little diagram. I'm sorry. I'm left-handed, I'm using my mouse right-handed, don't ask me why. But anyway, for the sake of the diagram, let's say it's a top-down view of a turn fight. The black line is your enemy, and he's in a Spitfire. The yellow line is you, and you're in a BF-109. Now, you can't exactly turn fight with a Spitfire on its own terms. As you notice, the black line is nice and tight, and he's kind of zigzagging, trying to get you to break off his six and bleed you of your energy. But you're going to stick it to him. You're going to bring this turn fight to your own terms. You're going to do a series of high or low yo-yos, and that is an aerial maneuver. Kind of, I really don't know how to explain how to do it. If you're unfamiliar with what the maneuver is, I highly suggest educating yourself, because it's invaluable. But basically, you're doing a series of small boom and zooms, and that's what you're going to use to maintain your energy and put yourself into firing solutions and retain your energy, create energy, and hopefully, when he realizes that he's not going to be able to break you, he's going to have to level off, and he's going to want to speed away. But you'll have, hopefully, an energy advantage, altitude advantage, and you'll be able to pounce and end the fight. Because basically what he's trying to do is turn tight and get you to follow him exactly. Like, he just wants you to follow him. He knows that he can turn tighter than you, so either he'll end up on your six, or you'll end up with no energy. And you'll have to level off, and you'll have to try to gain your speed. And usually at that time, that's when they'll pounce on you. That's when he has his energy advantage, his altitude advantage, and just puts you in a bad way. This next set of diagrams shows you a more difficult maneuver, but my favorite one to pull off. And this requires them to be on your six, so this time they're chasing you. You really got to know your aircraft. You really got to know the aircraft that's chasing you. And practice, practice, practice. This is where a maneuver like the hammerhead comes in. Basically, what you're going to do, if you're in a higher energy state than the person pursuing you, and you know you have a better climb rate and energy retention, or the possibility of such, you're going to get them to chase you upwards. Maybe not straight vertical, but you want to get them to be bleeding off more energy than you are and following you in the climb. Now what's going to happen is, at some point, they're going to start staggering off, and you're going to notice this. Simulator battles, it's harder to judge because of the spotting and everything, but in realistic battle, we're going to go ahead and assume that you've got target lock on this guy. And this is where my key binding is Alt, and that's a camera lock, basically. Your camera will lock onto your target. I use that a lot. That's another valuable little tip and trick right there. Use it. It helps so much, especially when you have someone following you or you're trying to do crazy maneuvers like this one. So anyway, when they get to the point where they're losing energy, you'll see them dropping off, assuming that you've locked onto them. You'll see that you're gaining more distance more rapidly. And then at some point, if they don't realize what's going on, or they just are convinced that they're going to be able to catch you, they'll stall. And that's where you're going to pounce, and that's where you're going to kill them. Now, following the black line, you can see he's climbing, and he starts staggering, and then he drops off. That's where he stalls.
you are climbing, keep climbing. And this loop at the top is more representative than actual, this is what you should do. This just represents a maneuver. Whatever you need to do to put yourself in position to take advantage of them being in that stall, do it. Just make sure that you're able to recover from whatever it is that you're doing, and that's beneficial. I tend to loop. I actually do a physical loop, or I force my plane into a stall and try to do a maneuver like the hammerhead. Then you're basically booming and zooming again. You'll drop on the target, he'll be in a stall, he won't be able to maneuver his plane, he won't be able to do anything. Boom, boom, boom. Kill, zoom, zoom, zoom. Changing the colors a little bit here, you're going to notice the black line turns to red. That's where it's critical. You need to know when this is happening and take advantage of it. Otherwise, it's pointless. Otherwise, it might allow you to escape, but if you want the kill, you need to realize when this starts happening and realize what you need, or start working out what you need to do in your mind to get your aircraft in that killing position. Which brings me to why your line has actually turned purple. Again, key factor of this maneuver is whatever you got to do to put yourself in that killing strike position, do it. Just know what you're going to do. Have a plan. Flying by the seat of your pants in moments like this isn't always beneficial. You want to act. You don't want to react. You want to put yourself, you want this guy to be like, wow, I totally messed up. He totally put me in that position. He knows it. You know it. And you fly away a happy man or woman. I'm going to show you some of this in action here.
All right, you can see I'm dropping in on two bandits. I really want to try and take the guy with altitude. Miss. Put pressure on his friend. Miss. But notice I don't chase them. I don't turn into them. I don't make that mistake. I'm relying on them doing that. Now they have to turn back into me. They're going to drain their energy while I've managed to build energy. Start my vertical. Got that one bandit following. Start my loop because I'm pretty sure he's going to be running out of energy fairly soon. Got my loop now, aileron roll. There he is, duck in the water. Or fish in a barrel, rather. Get the critical. Get a pot shot on his friend. Zoom away once more. Again, not following, not pursuing, braking, gaining distance. This is the view from that first Spitfire, or the Spitfire that I criticaled, rather. He's pitching up. Sure, he can see me stall out. He's thinking, oh, I got this guy. And he stalls out. He knows he's in trouble. He tries to roll, but I'm able to get the critical on his tail section, which actually puts him down. I end up getting the kill. Diving in on this, I believe it's a hurricane, trying to save a friendly Dora. Pretty much did like a low yo-yo, diving as I turn to gain energy so that I could climb back up and close the gap between Tommy Boy and I. Tommy Boy let off those rockets. decides he's out. And here I am again, doing that diving turn to build energy. And there I am, I'm able to close the gap a little bit. As he's diving away, he ends up gaining a little distance on me. I'm able to get a hit on his tail. Apparently I took out his landing gear. He's maneuvering, rolling, trying to be evasive. His plane's probably not responding as well as he would like. He's also got those rails on his wings from the rockets. I'm able to put some damage on him. I think he may have throttled down, tried to force the overshoot. I pitch up. Aileron roll. Hi, yo-yo. And I could just keep doing this. Rinse and repeat. Rinse and repeat. But notice I'm watching him the whole time, just in case he decides to do something crazy, I can make an adjustment or decide to break off the attack and reset. But he doesn't, I don't think his plane, he has total control over his plane. I'm able to slot right in for the kill. Alright, well, I hope you all enjoyed this look at energy fighting. As always, if you have questions, comments, or thoughts, leave them below, as they could only help me grow. I'm happy to hear from you and happy to respond. There's a lot to go over that you just can't really touch on in a 20-minute video, so I hope this promotes a little discussion. And as I always say, fly high. Keep your heads on a swivel, and I will see you on those digital fields of battle.